Wylam, and your frequency is in tune with the ghetto truth with African Americans Ain't African.
A boy is born in hot dot Mississippi, surrounded by four walls that ain't so pretty. His parents give him love and affection to keep him strong, moving in the right direction, living just enough, just enough for the city.
Edition of African Americans Ain't African, the talk show that proves without a shadow of a doubt that the so-called African American didn't find his way to America locked in the trunk of a ship. I'm your host, Buck Wylam, and tonight you're in for a very, very special
very, very special treat indeed. This is African Americans Ain't Africans, broadcast live, the Ghetto Truth Radio in stereo, and Ghetto Truth Magazine, I'm sorry. I'm Gabriel Rich. I am standing in for Buck Wylam. Buck is still purifying himself in the waters of Lake Minnetonka tonight. What we're going to do tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to actually talk about something that's been on our minds for a minute. I've actually gotten some information over the past couple of weeks about it. I'm sure I've seen Nisi actually send out some information or get some information or post some information about the whole out of Africa theory, and we're going to debunk it. Really, that's what we're going to do. We're going to pick it apart tonight. We're going to pick it apart. If we're African Americans, then we're going to talk about it tonight to see if indeed we are or we are not African Americans. So that is the goal tonight. That is what we are going to do. So we are pretty much going to break it all down. We are going to talk about not only when I say America, I mean Pan-American, not just North America, but we're talking North and South America, because to be as we have so-called scholars who are Pan-Africanists, then we are Pan-Americans, because the Americas stretches from the bottom of the world to the top of the world. So we are going to discuss it tonight, and there's things I wanted to going to bring a few people on. A few guests on that we're going to have a roundtable discussion, and here's something that I just want you guys to consider really quick. All right, so we've been told that humanity descended from Africa first as hominid missing links between human and animals before evolving into Homo sapiens. Okay, those Homo sapiens then allegedly walked out of Africa to all parts of the earth except, of course, the Americas. So the Americas was like barren; they want nothing here. I guess I don't know. Where indigenous people, we're told, look like Tonto, okay? So, and that didn't come until much later, if they indeed look like Tonto that we saw from the Lone Ranger back in the day. But the problem with this theory is twofold. One, there's no real proof this ever happened. And two, because of white supremacy, we've basically been inclined to take these white scholars at their word and believe what we've been told by them, so much so that it is infiltrated through the university system. It is propagated through the university system, and a lot of our so-called scholars have now adapted their views, which is not good. That means that there's been no critical thinking on our own part to question what we've been told, and we take that they say as we all evolving out of Africa as a compliment, but a compliment to who exactly? So, just saying. But here's the thing. History teaches us to never believe what we're told by Europeans and white people in general. Common sense also dictates that we do our own research, and for anyone that has done the due diligence, they know the out-of-Africa theory is just that, a theory established out of both ignorance and short-sightedness by European scholars and also a hidden agenda to further their rank in the construct we know as racism and white supremacy. Besides, any intelligent European knows they're not the originators of this planet, despite all the media propaganda to the contrary. So they can't ever say that, you know, they were the originators. They basically, we all came from them. They already know better than that. They're not that dumb, all right? They're dumb, yes, but they're not that dumb. They have an agenda, yes, but their agenda can't include that because no one will believe it, all right? Because we've seen them in their tribal state, and they're unlike anybody else in theirs. So, yeah, so much for that. And I won't even call it tribal. Let's call it clannish. And there's a difference between a tribe and a clan. Okay. Besides, if anyone takes the time to break down the theory, the more they realize that it just doesn't make sense. There's a reason why it's been disputed over the century by everyone from ancient Chinese to Europeans themselves. The belief of monogenism is short-sighted and out of tune with nature itself, something that has defined indigenous Afro-Americans even today, whether we realize it or not. The reality, the likelihood that mankind started out of Africa is not only realistic, not only studies anthropology, but geography as well. If you study geography and land, all right, you'll notice one thing. If you want to study something about land areas, land mass, just study the mountains. The Appalachians are some of the oldest mountains on Earth. They're mountains that are rounded, all right? Round mountains are those that have been there for a while. The Himalayas or anything like that, a new jagged high mountain like that, they're new mountains. Even the Rockies. The Rockies are the newer mountains on the North American continent. They're much, much younger than that of the Appalachians, who their slopes are rounded, well-rounded, full of trees, full of, you know, the Rockies, it's just rocks. That's why they call it the Rockies, all right? And I'm not suggesting that there aren't any mountains that exist like that in Africa. There are, but they haven't been proven to be older than that of those in North America, especially. Just saying, something to consider, all right? So tonight we're going to just discuss this out-of-Africa theory and how it has affected us over the centuries, and especially today because we have a slew of people that are going around calling themselves African-Americans. Indeed, most of us now consider themselves African-Americans. And keep in mind that we've only been African-Americans since 1988. Jesse Jackson, that dude, I ain't even going to get into that. We won't get into that until later. But, yeah, think about that and consider that. So my guests with me tonight be Nisha Lachelle, Michael Hampton, and I'm sure we're going to have a few other guests. I'm not sure if Rick Moon is with us tonight. I do believe, however, that Rick will be tuning in and he will discuss with us. So we're just going to break it down tonight. We're going to talk about this because, quite frankly, it needs to be talked about more. You know, the fact that we just don't even question it goes to our subscription or our subscribing into white supremacy and the belief that if white people tell us something, we should believe it. And the reality is most of the time when white people tell us something, it ain't good for us, all right? It's not to our best benefit. Being out of Africa is not a compliment. The reality is that most indigenous people who created, who came out of the land, who formed out of the soil, we've been here so long that we were once green. Because remember, your hemoglobin is green. All right, so we've been here that long, and we are a combination of many things, all right, but it didn't just walk out of one continent and walk everywhere else. And believe it, and also keep in mind for them, they believe a man did it. So how can a man pretty much go everywhere else and just procreate? So, yeah, I mean, yeah, they talk about Lucy, but most of the time, they when they think of the evolutionary chain, it's a man. So, okay, what, was he having sex with trees, or was he what? What's up? I don't know. All I know is the more I studied it, the more it doesn't make any sense. So we're going to talk about it tonight, and we're going to, you know, just put it out on the table. We're not suggesting that you guys take everything that we say as the truth. Look it up for yourself. We'll give you some information. We'll send you some information, some links which you can check out if you want to check out what we're saying. I mean, hey, if you want to dispute it, dispute it. That's what we're here for. I'm quite sure we'll accommodate you in terms of a good debate. You know, it can be a good spirited debate. We'll all accommodate you. We're all game. We're all down for it. So tonight I just want to bring on Nisha Lachelle. Hi, Nisha.
Hey, how you doing, beloved, my brother?
How you doing, my queen, my sister?
It's all good.
Mike Hampton? How's it going, Mike?
I'm right here. Right here. How's it going, Brother Gabe and Nisha?
What's the haps, brother man?
Hey, brother.
What's the half? All right. Rick Moon. Hey. What's happening, Rick Moon? What's going on, brother?
James, how's it going? How's everybody else doing? Mike, Nisi?
Hey, beloved
Making
brother.
It.
All
right. Hey, we hanging, baby, but we're not like a slave, so we all good.
Some of us are still slave-minded now. You know?
Yeah, well, I didn't say we had all the cobwebs shaking out.
For real. Right, right.
So, panel, this out of Africa theory, all right? I mean, you know, we're still into this. And quite frankly, it's not going to go away because it's been so ingrained into us literally since what? Technically since the 60s, the whole African-American study program, and even before then, the whole Pan-Africanism, all of this. I mean, you know, what is up? Why are we still here? Why haven't we – I won't say why are we still here, because we know why. All right, but why haven't we taken the time as a people to break this down, considering that, you know, 99.7% of us are indigenous?
Why? I think it's because we don't want to be accountable for doing further investigative inquiry ourselves.
Right.
And someone gave us this, and to be honest with you, because we all do our research and we're still researching, and that's what I love about my crew members who are my brothers and sisters and stuff, you know, that are part of this network. Now, mainstream academia, this is European, Imano-European fighting each other. Okay, let's put that out there.
Yes.
This has been, they've already said that mainstream academia does not want the out of Africa theory debunked, but they know that it is not accurate, it is not correct, it is not true. I'm going to tell you who came up with it, and this didn't catch on as in ignite, so to speak, until the 90s, and that was Professors Alan C. Wilson and Rebecca L. Khan, I guess, however you pronounce the name, C-A-N-N.
Mm-hmm.
Now, to their defense, with the whole their whole theses and all, they always, the post set was an assumption. It was never even an assertion, and it just caught on, because what they wanted to do with it is to remove the whole concept of race with it. So if everybody came from the same place, then, you know, there's no concept of race. But what
right.
we got to remember is when we go back and look in the 1700s at some of these quacks, they were always trying to come up and legitimate the differences in, you know, the various groups of people.
Right.
They themselves are all over the place. And if you are a thinking person, that ought to make you say, right there. So, you know, but like they said, see, they've this Professor Khan and Wilson, they faded into the woodwork, but they're still there, I do believe. And they're like, okay, we set an assumption. But then they go right into their own litany of their papers and say, because they're fully aware that genealogy cannot be completely linked to geography. Okay?
Exactly.
So
exactly.
You have to, if you're walking this walk of knowledge, and I like to say to get to the knowledge of awareness and understanding, then you can't be afraid of where it takes you. You got to shine your light on it. And people can't, I don't know what their reasoning is for embracing something that more and more, even both groups, you know, because you got the pro group and the con group, and most of the groups of these Europeans, they're already saying it's just not true, and it never was true, but it had an agenda behind it.
What do you think, Mike?
Well, I look at it like, I mean, when most people who do take the time to research or just go to images and X, you know, where indigenous people or a certain tribe name, you know, or Cherokee, or those are the common names that were switched, they will find paintings and the artist's name, the article of the year that they even painted the picture. And they wouldn't paint them white or, should I say, Caucasian looking or you know, mixed, that's on the reservation now, you know, that looks like Asian. you see dark-skinned people with afros, woolly hair. You know, some ass straight. That's evidence right there. I mean, Europeans, when they came over here, or the missionaries, and just started, you know, painting everything white, you know, they had to get inside us, let's say the tribe and everything, the culture, and learn everything about us. So, I mean, that's evidence right there. I know most would say, well, those are Africans, you know. As far as the book, a lot of African-Americans would fight you on the they came before Columbus, Dr. Yeah. Ivan Van Sertima. Yeah, he's been debunked many times, man. I don't think he quite really, you know, he would buy that word as well, that these were Africans, the Olmecs, when he was down in Mexico, you know.
We'll get into Van Sertima later. I've met him. I know Buck met him. I believe Rick, you also met Dr. Van Sertima, right?
Oh, yeah. Met him, his wife, his whole family.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm quite sure you know the deal as well. What do you think, Rick? What are your thoughts on this whole out of Africa theory?
Well, first of all, you know, when I think about this out of Africa theory, I like to think of it as, you know, in reality, like in nature. And the thing is, when I look into nature, I know that the natural environment in the United States is the forest. North America itself is the forest. So, excuse me, knowing that, you know, when I go into the forest, and I know people have heard me say this on numerous occasions, you know, I like to, you know, take people there with me, and we can just, you know, look at ourselves in the forest and see how you blend in with everything in that forest, the trees, the rocks, the soil, even the animals. You're the same color as the animal. Every indigenous people are the same color as the earth. So all the colors of the earth are all the colors of us, because that's where we came from.
Right.
And knowing this, I always, you know, look to nature, and I see how much I fit in with it, and, well, not to myself, but I look at my family members and other people of our indigenous status and see how they blend in everything, and they can see that I blend in too. And, you know, that right there tells me I'm home. You know, and you can also imagine other people being in those same forests. You can imagine white Europeans being in that forest. You can even imagine Africans in that forest, and they will not blend in with it because they come from a totally different environment. You, even these Native Americans, they'll stick out in the forest like a sore thumb. And whenever I talk to them about that, you know, argue them about that, that's the first thing I tell them. Let's go to the forest and let's find out who blends in and who don't. Then they start calling me racist and all this other stuff. So, you know
what? What? You mean to tell me that Tonto will stick out like a I ain't gonna say what he would stick out like, but yeah. I get your point, man.
Yeah.
I definitely get your point. You know, and you're actually correct. Again, you know, you're talking about the fact that we've been here so long, again, that we pretty much come from the earth. And we've been here so long that it predates history that man can, at least Europeans can try to quantify or qualify, I should say. All right, so we've been here so long that we were once green. All right, so from us, everything flows, particularly with being in tune with nature, being in tune with the land. Africans come from a different terrain than we come from, a different environment, a different land mass, different terrain than we do. There's no question about that. They don't move like we move. They don't, you know.